Well, good morning and welcome to your Sunday Gardener. I'm John Collins, along with Carrie Engel from Valley View Farms. And once again, we're at the Rawlings Conservatory in Druid Hill Park. And this morning, we're kind of imagining we're in a tropical rainforest.
Costa Rica, maybe?
Perhaps in Central America, right. great place to visit, but actually, it'd be a lot cheaper to come to Druid Hill Park and come to the Rawlings Conservatory. Beautiful displays in this room of all kinds of tropical plants. They have a great little fish pond over there with goldfish.
I saw bananas.
And bananas.
Nice ripe bananas.
Right. And they have some plants that are millions of years old, at least the species is.
Right, the cycads, right?
Yes, right. And we have a big fern behind us.
This is great. This is an Australian tree fern. I don't know if you can get under here and take a look at this trunk, but they are very, very cool. These like to stay pretty wet. So if you have one in your house, definitely it's one of the few plants where I say don't let it dry out.
Yeah.
I'm always talking about drainage. My back is
your
totally
back
today,
is to
so
the
I'm
camera,
so sorry.
Yes. What is on this wall behind us here?
Those are all sorts of epiphytic plants. All the way up there you can see a staghorn fern, and that fern just keeps growing out from its shield. There's all sorts of tillandsias up there, and tillandsias are also epiphytic.
There's a wire mesh on the wall, and these plants are kind of attached to that.
Yeah, they're not in soil at all. So there are some of these you can do at home and have some fun with. One of the ones that you're pretty familiar with is this. This is a bromeliad. This is one we call Guzmania. Mm-hmm. They come in some bright reds and pinks and yellows. And then this one I think is kind of cool. This is Cyanea. And just some interesting foliage. It sends this up and then little flowers off to the side.
Now, these are the type of things that are in that wall. And they need a little soil to be anchored. And they don't have to be in a wall, of course.
Right. Well, they can be in moss. They can be actually grow in like the crotches of trees. But they just really don't need a lot of soil. And even more so are what we commonly call these air plants.
I'll just grab a handful here. And that's
there you
what's,
go.
That's what's hanging on this. In addition to being up there, they're also hanging on this little rope.
Yep.
Thing.
And this is cool. This is a variety called Ionanthus, again, a type of tillandsia. And you can see there's a bunch of these little guys that have just sort of all kind of one grows out of the other to make that ball form.
Mm-hmm.
But these are very cool. And
those things really aren't roots as much as they are anchors.
Exactly. They're just something to hold it, again, in trees and things. If you go down to even southern Florida, these are growing up through the trees.
So do you water these or what?
You kind of do. Now, I've always told people to miss them, but I've looked a little more into it this year because we have a lot more of them. And what we're doing now is we're soaking them well once a week, just for a couple of hours in a bucket of water, and then taking them out.
And drop them in the bucket.
Yep.
This one even
that's all they really need.
This one even has some flowers on it, little pink flowers.
They're very cool, and there's some that have these really like Medusa-type shapes. This
right.
one is one of the bulbosas, has a real thick bulb on the bottom, and then that kind of cool shape.
But they're pretty tough, right? My house is a real challenge for any plant that's growing
they're
in.
They're very tough.
This would work.
They're very tough, and they're inexpensive.
Mm-hmm.
So you can take one of these, and the terrariums we talked about a while back, the little earth orbs, throw one of these in there with a handful of stones, and they'll do fine.
Kids would love these.
Yes.
And they're pretty indestructible.
They are pretty indestructible.
Yeah.
They're not totally, but pretty good.
Yeah, they'll last for a while. They're great for a winter plant in the house, great for a little project, great for kids to play with.
And it's just neat to look at just how varied the plant world is. When you come to a place like this at the Rawlings Conservatory, you really do get a sense of just how broad the plant world is.
Absolutely. So, these are fun to have in the house, but in Baltimore, there's a great resource. Bring the kids, bring the family down to the Rawlings Conservatory. This particular room is the tropical room.
And bring the camera.
There's
this
lots of fun.
Great
oh, absolutely.
Places.
And there's some neat goldfish over there, too. Next Sunday, we'll be back here at Rawlings to talk more about plants in your house. Bring a little bit of the world into your house on your Sunday Gardener. Thanks for joining us this morning,
Thank
Carrie,
you.
And you, too.
If you have a garden question, send it to Sunday Gardener, WBAL-TV, 3800 Hooper Avenue, Baltimore, Maryland, 21211. You can also go on our website, WBALTV.com, and stay with us. More news to come.